Do you know the interviews he's doing?
What?
Saying that being married to me were the best years of his life. He's now wearing his ring full time.
Yeah.
Your ring. You were wearing it when you were someone too. He doesn't think we're going through with a divorce. I'll always be his wife and he'll never call me anything else.
People change for various reasons, and losing lots of weight could cause changes in your mind and body, and improves overall health and reduces the risk of certain health conditions. And celebrities, well, they're just like all of us. They think about their well-being and try to maintain a healthy diet. But what differs them from us is that they get criticized more often for their weight than us. Lots of celebrities have shed serious weight through diet and exercise over the years, and today we are going to see celebrity weight loss moments that were borderline dangerous. Number 6. Jessica Simpson. Jessica Simpson is definitely an inspiration to any busy mom who has been struggling with their weight. Like so many women, Simpson opened up about her weight gain during pregnancy and her desire to not only lose the baby weight, but to forge a new healthy habit that will help her keep the weight off once and for all. She actually lost not less than 100 pounds and looks so different that it's even hard to tell if this woman really is Jessica Simpson. But how did she do it? She eventually worked her way up to get at least 14,000 steps a day. She also revealed her magical secret in an Instagram post, saying, "Woke up before all three kiddos to get my steps in and spend time with me, myself, and I. Move, move, move for your own mental health." Simpson is also focused on eating 3 healthy, protein-packed meals a day and 2 snacks, which is almonds. Instead of cheat days, she would have several cheat meals throughout the week, and that way she didn't feel deprived of her favorite foods. She didn't forget about her sleep schedule as well, which is one of the most important aspects of general well-being. Unfortunately, so many people undervalue the importance of sleep and weight loss and weight management, but the fashion mogul Simpson aimed for 7 hours a night. Number 5. Kelly Osbourne. She had surgery. She did it, and she is totally proud of it. Yes, that's the bravery from Kelly Osbourne. She finally looks happy after finding success on a lifelong weight loss journey. "I was called fat and ugly in the press almost my entire life. I understand that being judged by others comes with the territory, but it broke my heart and ruined my self-esteem. It sets you up to hate yourself in a huge way. I was so angry about the things people said about me. I truly believe it's the main reason I turned to Vicodin and ended up in rehab 3 times. I just hated myself," said Osbourne, and she decided to change it all. This summer, she shared her success and she opened up about how she did it on a podcast. It's not only about gastric sleeve surgery, but she changed her lifestyle in a meaningful way as well. Maybe that's the reason for her looking so super awesome. Who needs less weight if you are not happy with being yourself, right? "The number one thing I had to do was get happy," she said. "I had to fix my head before I could fix my body. You can never go into this if you're not in a good mindset, and it's impossible not to agree." For Kelly, undergoing surgery wasn't the easiest option when it comes to weight management. She says she had to push through a year of preparation before she even went under the knife. "But it's not enough. The kind of surgery I had, if you don't work out and you don't eat right, you gain weight. All it does is move you in the right direction. So anyone who's thinking of doing something like this really should think about that," she explained. Number 4. Drew Carey. Back in 2010, Drew Carey realized his love of beer and junk food had packed on the pounds. To start with, he initially weighed around 262 pounds, and after becoming fed up with the excess weight he was carrying, he decided to set a goal of losing about 90 pounds. In addition to weighing that much, Drew also had a size 44 waist. But by the end of the year, he had managed to reduce this number down to size 34, and he achieved a corresponding weight of roughly 170 pounds. He also used to have type 2 diabetes, but he threw it away in the trash as well. Now you might be wondering how he did it, right? Well, no worries, as we're going to tell you his secrets. He confessed that his commitment to a healthier diet and regular exercise for 12 months was the only real secret that worked for him. On top of that, he made great use of a low-carb diet strategy that involved cutting out all the pasta and bread that he used to enjoy regularly. "No carbs," he said. "I have cheated a couple of times, but basically no carbs, not even a cracker, no bread at all, no pizza, nothing. No corn, no beans, no starches of any kind. Egg whites in the morning are like Greek yogurt, cut some fruit." The most difficult thing in the whole process could be finding the motivation to stick to your plan. But one of the smartest tricks Drew used to motivate himself was to remember a phrase he had learned from Kate Moss. nothing tastes as good as skinny feels. Armed with his motivating quote, he managed to subdue any cravings for long enough to lose a considerable amount of weight. Number 3. John Goodman. The longtime actor John Goodman has had a tremendous career that has spanned several decades, where he always managed to remain a force to be reckoned with on screen. From charming comedic characters to total badasses, to a general scene-stealing mammoth of a man, John Goodman's presence is something audiences have always felt, regardless of his physical appearance or weight. As he said, he's battled with yo-yo dieting throughout most of his career, something that was compounded by his alcohol addiction. But later, John stated that the secret behind his 100-pound weight loss was portion control. However, he also admitted that the first thing he cut from his diet was alcohol. That and hiring a personal trainer and working out 6 days a week is what helped to keep the weight off permanently. In terms of his weight loss, there's been a lot of folks who have attributed surgery to helping him keep the poundage off, with many speculating that he's undergone gastric bypass to do so. Seeing as how open he's been with his personal struggles with alcohol and overeating, along with his depression issues, it's hard to imagine that he wouldn't be candid with that. So no, there's really nothing documented to suggest that John Goodman has had surgery to help with his weight loss. Number 2. Jonah Hill. When it comes to transformations, Jonah Hill is just one of the best examples, especially in terms of showcasing dramatic weight loss. After Channing Tatum told him that, yes, obviously eating less and exercising with a trainer would help him lose a few, Hill consulted a few nutritionists who suggested he start a food diary to log his daily diet. A friend of mine was like, if you do 100 push-ups a day, you'll be in good shape. I worked my way up, and now I do that every day, he said in an interview. Countless paparazzi shots prove that Hill goes to the gym, and the push-ups aren't his only exercise. But clearly his friend was on to something. While he added consistent exercise, the star came to terms with one thing he tried to cut back on. Beer. I still drink beer. That is my Achilles heel. It's so annoying, because if I don't drink beer, I get really thin. And then when I drink a beer, I get a little bigger. While working with a nutritionist, Hill revealed a food that seemed to work for him, telling outlets, I found the Japanese food was very helpful to me. He reportedly incorporated more sushi into his diet. Sushi is a relatively low-calorie food, assuming you don't go for the fried sauce rolls, and it has plenty of omega-3 fatty acids that contribute to a healthy metabolism. Number 1. Khloe Kardashian. It is hard to believe that Khloe Kardashian was struggling with her confidence, right? Because she actually was. The youngest of the first-gen Kardashian sisters, tall-framed Khloe, was always chubby as a kid and did not pay much attention to her lifestyle. But like a blessing in disguise, her tumultuous personal life actually opened her eyes and helped her change her unhealthy lifestyle. Losing about 3 stones is not easy. Neither does it happen overnight, especially when you harbor bad eating and lifestyle habits. In an interview, Khloe said, growing up, I was always chubby. I used to just accept the way that people defined me. When people called me the fat sister, I'd say, yeah, I'm big boned. Whatever we do to laugh at things instead of letting them hurt you. And then I slowly but surely took something really bad in my life or a stressful time, which was my divorce, and I turned it into a positive. She coped with the extreme stress of divorce and channeled the negative energy by working out. She said, I decided to turn to fitness as a form of therapy and as a stress reliever. Did any of these celebrities inspire you? Let us know in the comments down below. Make sure you subscribe to our channel and turn on those post notifications so you never miss a video from us.
I just said, we don't care what you're doing, like meaning like we don't care if you want to transition. We want to support you and be there for you.
Right.
But we don't think that entails you speaking negatively about my mom. In our opinion, you don't need to even mention our mom.